I'm Julian Tuckett, and welcome to Literacies in Early Childhood. This video is subtitled, and all references are included at the end of the presentation. There are two parts to this video. First, we'll look at some of the theoretical concepts informing literacy definitions, perspectives of learning, and practices children need to develop. Then I'll detail how this theory can inform teaching by describing one way that children can engage with multimodal texts by using technology to recreate a story. The first concept is that the definitions of literacy have broadened. The term itself was pluralized to reflect multimodality and repertoires of practice beyond the core skills of reading and writing. There's now much greater emphasis on how students participate in constructing meaning. These changing paradigms require changing pedagogies, which consider children as creators and innovators. So classrooms should aim for student-centered learning, encourage collaboration, and foster autonomy. Language learning is at the heart of literacy, so effective teaching requires understanding from different perspectives. Here are two fundamental theories which differ on how they conceive the learning process, but have both improved educational approaches. Developmental theory is that we learn in stages through cognitive constructionism. It sees learners in an active role and has contributed to a more student-focused approach. Whereas sociocultural theory is that we learn in communities through social constructivism and sees language as a shared resource between competent users who support learners to incrementally internalize it. This theory has led to a more collaborative and socially interactive approach. To address the question of what to learn, researchers have constructed theoretical frameworks to categorize the range of literary practices learners need in their repertoires. One influential framework is the four resources model, which states that literacy competence requires learners to develop the four roles of code breaker, meaning maker, text user, and text analyst. We will now examine an example of how the multiliteracies framework can be applied in a primary education setting. Reading a picture book to the class, then letting the students retell the story using tablets. On the slight chance that someone besides my teacher is watching this, I've included a link in the description to the amazing video which gave me the idea. Advocating for more screen time may seem counter to the popular narrative that it's causing social isolation and childhood obesity, but a recent study found that the way most children are engaging with technology is more likely to promote social interaction, build on interests, and supplement learning. The issue is quality, not quantity. For example, interactive story apps might appear to be both entertaining and educational, but they're actually not likely to really engage children if all they allow is clicking through sequential learning tasks. But story-making apps are didactic tools that allow playful innovation and learner agency. Giving students tablets and setting them the task of retelling a story in pairs is empowering them to actively engage in the social process of learning and the opportunity to produce and share original multimedia stories. It's also fantastic for literacy's development. When children retell a story, it undergoes imaginative transformation and is actually one of the highest forms of learning. That's because narratives are essentially a lens through which to perceive the world and one's place in it. In the retelling of a story, it becomes a dynamic space for a child's self to interact with the external world. And research consistently demonstrates that story retelling enhances literacy and language development, especially comprehension and expressive vocabulary. The final two concepts for the effective application of this activity are story transformation and a supportive context. The goal of retelling is not to identically reproduce the original. Students benefit the most when they elaborate on the source text by relating it to their personal experiences and interests. Encouraging students to transfer the setting or expand the plot not only fuels their imagination, it allows them to project themselves into the story. Each learner brings a unique social and cultural background to the class, so when they share their transformed stories, it facilitates improved cultural awareness. Even if the students come from similar cultural backgrounds, no two households are exactly the same, so the children are exposed to different family structures and lifestyles. In a supportive and non-judgmental classroom, this practice fosters empathy, because the child who reads lives 1,000 lives, and the child who authors multimodal narratives can share theirs with the world. In conclusion, this video first examined theoretical constructs currently informing the pedagogy of literacies in early childhood. The concept of literacy has become more inclusive. Language learning theories inform educators from diverse perspectives, and learners are taught a plurality of literacy practices. This video also analysed the importance of multimodal literacy and provided a specific example of using technology to empower young learners to engage with their literacies development by discussing, modifying, and recreating stories. Thank you for this subject. Teaching early childhood literacies is absolutely one of the most important tasks in the world. I'm grateful that this subject pushed me to explore an informed, balanced, and practical approach. And the fact that this learning was via reconstructing meaning in a multimodal text is sublime.